Welcome to our session today. Today we are going to discuss something on geography, standard 7, and our topic is photograph and map interpretation. Photograph and map interpretation. And our subtopic is physical features on topographical maps. Physical features found on topographical maps. So we can identify various physical features which are found in our topographical maps. By definition, what is a topographical map? A topographical map is the type of map which shows both natural features and man-made features. The type of map which shows both natural features and man-made features, they are well known as topographical maps. And therefore, how can we identify the features which are found within the topographical maps? We can say that we can identify physical features by using contour lines. So what is a contour? Or what, when you talk about contour lines, a contour are imaginary lines which are drawn on the map to connect places with the same height above the sea level. I repeat, contour or a contour line. A contour lines, these are imaginary lines drawn on a map to connect places with the same height above the sea level. So we can use contour lines to identify topographical or to identify features which are found on topographical maps. We can use contour lines or contour lines or these imaginary lines to identify the various relief features found on topographical maps. For example, when you're talking about the relief features or the physical features, what are the examples of these features? Before we use the contour, we can see that the relief, or we call the physical features, this include, it can be hills, it can be valleys, it can be a river, it can be a forest, it can be, let's say, plateau, etc., and etc. There are so many. So these physical features or relief features, we can use contour maps to identify them. Number one, or to begin with, a hill. How can we identify that this is what? A hill, by using contour lines. A hill, we know that it is just a raised land above the sea level. A hill, it can be a hill or a mountain. How can we use a contour to identify a hill or a mountain? Let's say that this is a hill. So this hill, by using contour lines or all those imaginary lines, we can depict or we can identify a hill when a contour map is like this, or when the contour lines are like this. So when the contour lines are close to each other, they represent a hill. When they show a feature like this, or when you come across a contour lines which are like this, this one normally represent what? Represent a hill. And remember, contour are normally numbered. We can start by 50, we go to 100, we go to 150, 200, and the peak will be 250. So at this point, let's say that point is point A. At point A, there we have what? This is what? A hill, and that is the peak of the hill or the peak of the mountain. And always, don't forget this, contours are measured in what? In meters. Though they will not indicate 50 meters, 100 meters, but at the back of your mind, contours are measured by meters. So number one, we have a hill. Therefore, we can identify a hill when we see a contour feature or a contour map like this. What do I mean? I mean, this contour map represents what? A hill. Number two, we can also identify something called a plateau. What is a plateau? By definition, we say that a plateau, it is a raised land with a top tableland at the top. We say that a raised land, but at the top we have a flat area. So it is a raised land with a top tableland. This is what we call a plateau. The same plateau, we can identify a plateau by using contour map. For example, when you come across a contour map like this, when the contour lines are drawn like this, this one represents what? A plateau. This one represents what? A plateau. When the contour map looks like this, this one represents what? A plateau. So you can see, we can identify a plateau by looking on contour map. That is number two. Number three, we have something called a pass. A pass. A pass is one among the relief features whereby it is an opening between the hills or between the mountains. And it is a place whereby the roads and the railway lines are being constructed. We say that a pass, it is just an opening between the highlands or between the hills. So a pass is sometimes it looks like this. Let's say this is a mountain, then here we have an opening. So this opening here, we call it a pass. So how can we identify a pass by using contour maps? When you see a contour lines which looks like this, when you see a contour lines which represent a feature like this, this one actually represents a pass. When the contour lines are like this, let's say here we have 100, 150, let's say here we have 200, we have 150, we have 100, we have 50. So in between here, this is where we have what? A pass. So a pass, it is just an opening between the hills, an opening between the mountains, an opening or a space left between the mountains. So this is what we call a pass. So we can identify a pass by using contour maps. The other one, we have a valley. We can say a valley or a river. We can say a valley or a river. Let us also see it. How can we identify a valley or a river? A valley or a river. Number four. Valley or river. How can we identify a valley or a river by using a contour map? We can identify a valley or a river by using contour map. When you come across a contour map, such as when the lines or these imaginary lines are forming a V-shape or U-shape pointing up a hill. What do I mean? Let's say this is a valley or a river, but by using a contour map, how will it look like? This is just, let's say, a river, or it can be what? A valley. So by using a contour map, when we have this thing called the contour lines forming V shape pointing up a hill like this, pointing upright. It can be V-shaped or U-shaped, pointing upright. So this one normally represents a valley or what? A river. So you see, we can also identify valley or a river by using contour mesh, but only when the contour lines forming V-shape, they are forming V-shape pointing uphill. As you can see, our V-shape is pointing uphill. So this represents a valley or a river. Another thing, or another feature that can also be identified by using contour lines, we can talk about a cliff. Number five, we can talk about a cliff. A cliff, it is just a vertical or a very steep area found, a very, very, very steep area found between, especially at the shore of the ocean. This is where when the river, or not even the river, it is an area bordering the ocean and the land, but it is very steep, or it is a vertical area found within the shore of the world, of the ocean. So a cliff as a feature can also be identified by using contour mesh. How do it look like? This is the structure or the map or the contour map of a cliff. When the contour, or we say submerged contour, it is formed by submerged contour lines. So submerged contour lines, how do they look like? It is like this. As you can see, they are submerged. Meanwhile, that as if they are coming together at the meeting here. This is a water body. They say this is a sea. So, this place here, it is what we have a cliff. So, a cliff can be identified by submerged contour, or when contour are almost coming together. And we have said that a cliff, it is found just at the seashore. So this is how the image or the map looks like. Another feature that can be identified by using contour map, apart from a cliff, we have something called an estuary. An estuary, first of all, we have to know the definition of an estuary. Let us have the definition of an estuary. So an estuary, we have delta, all these are features, but we can also identify them by using contour mesh. We have this one here called an estuary. When we are talking about an estuary refers to a submerged, we call it a submerged feature found at the river mouth as the river enters the ocean or the lake. A very large submerged area found at the river mouth. So an estuary, as we can see, it is very large submerged as the river enters the world, the ocean. So we can say this is the sea, or we can say the ocean. Then we have a very submerged area whereby it is occupied by water. So this is our river, the river entering the world, the ocean. So this very, we call it a large submerged area at the river mouth. That's what we call what? An estuary. And remember, an estuary is found at the river mouth. So we have an estuary, but we have also what? A delta. What is the difference between these two? We have an estuary and we have the delta. Let us see the difference between the two. The difference between the two. Delta, we can say a low-lying area at the river mouth composed of various distributaries. A low-lying area at the river mouth composed by various distributaries. So, a delta, let's say this is our main river. This is our main river. But before the river enters the ocean, it forms some distributaries. This distributary, we can call them various channels formed by the running river before it enters the what? It enters the ocean. So here we can say we have the ocean. Here let's say we have the ocean or a lake, whatever, or the sea. So when these distributaries are formed, so normally it forms something called a triangular shape. It forms something like what? A triangular shape. So this triangular shape formed at the mouth of the river. This is what we call a delta. And a delta, it is composed by distributaries. Distributaries, these are various channels formed when the river reaches at a lower area, or in what? Say a gentle slope where it divides itself into various channels. So those channels we call them distributaries. So the difference between an estuary and a delta is that an estuary, it is just a large submerged feature formed at the river mouth. But a delta, we say that it is also formed at the river mouth at a low-lying area, but it is composed by various distributaries or various channels. But normally a delta forms a triangular shape at the river mouth. So these are some of the features that we can use contour map or contour lines to identify them. There are so many. Not only that, we have another one called a ridge. A ridge is just like a deep valley. It seems like a deep valley, but it can be more than one. Various valleys in a certain channel, but it can be more than one. So how can we identify a ridge? How can we identify a ridge? The diagram of a ridge, sometimes it looks like this. Let's say this is a ridge that we have. So this, we say, these features like valleys, here is what we have, what? A ridge. And a ridge can also be identified by using contour map. How can we identify it? When the contours are like this, when you come across a contour lines which looks like this, this one normally represents a ridge. That one normally represents what? A ridge. So we can see that contour maps or contour lines, they help us to identify various features found on topographical maps. And as we said before, a topographical map is a map that can be used to show both natural features and man-made features. So those natural features, like these physical features, we have seen how we can use the contour maps to identify these features. We have started with the valley, and we have seen that a valley can be represented when the contour mesh forms a V-shape pointing up ahead. We have also gone far and we have seen something known as a cliff, whereby we have said that a cliff is just is just formed by submerged contour lines. We have also seen something known as an estuary, whereby you have said that an estuary is just a submerged large, like a depression formed at the river mouth. A very, very big or large submerged area formed at the river mouth when the river enters the ocean. We have also seen a delta, whereby you see that a delta is composed by various distributaries, and these distributaries have said that they are just a channels which are formed at the river mouth before the river, or we say that the river split into itself before it enters the ocean, whereby it formed something like a triangular shape. So all this we can identify by using contour map. My last two questions. The first question is, imaginary lines drawn on the map that connects places with the same height above the sea level is known as, I'm not going to write the question, but I'll only read the question. An imaginary line drawn on the map connecting places with the same height above the sea level is known as, I need an answer. The second one, the distance between two consecutive contours is known as, this is a contour, or a contour map. So my question is, the difference between two consecutive contours, or let's say the difference between this contour and this contour, the difference between this one and this one, how do you call it? Let's say that here we have 50, 100, 150, and we have 200. So the difference between one contour and another, two different consecutive contours, that is the question. How do you call it? The difference, or the distance, we can say the distance between two consecutive contours, how do you call it? This distance and distance. So that's my second question. Thank you for listening. Let us meet next time.